There's all kinds of really exciting activity happening in blockchain and in artificial intelligence in China and throughout the region. And both of you are pioneers in it in different ways. Edith, at 500 startups, what are you seeing as the biggest focus in blockchain in the current cohort?
We're very excited to be, you know, part of the blockchain and crypto ecosystem. And in, I would say US and China is a little bit different in terms of type of blockchain companies that we get to invest in. In Silicon Valley, you see a lot of more foundational level protocol.
Infrastructure layer.
That's right. In not only scalability, identity, privacy, security, these are the protocols that we've been actively investing in. Versus in China, we see a lot more content, entertainment, and gaming focus. As you see, there's huge population in China, over 1.3 billion people. And there's definitely a lot of application that you don't see in the US.
And is that just because the payment infrastructure for payment of content isn't as well established in China, or in gaming payments isn't as well established?
So for example, I'm looking at this project called Cocos, and they already have over 1 million developers using their gaming engine for a long time. And you see all these weapons. If it's right. being developed in a particular engine, you can imagine these weapons could be used in multiple games. And let's say if one particular game shut down, all the users get really upset, but they can still use that weapons and token in other games that's built on the same engine.
I see.
Gamers natively love the concept of tokens right. and really gets the token economy. And then on top of that, China, more so than the US, really sort of get the virtual goods and tipping idea that, hey, if, you know, Tony, I really, yeah. really love, you know, this particular show, I just want to give you some flowers right. and token. Why not, right? And the fact that you receive this token, you can give it to other, you know, show content creators or other viewer as well. So it's basically built in the Chinese society.
Yeah, it's a cultural thing to actually use the tokens. And on that note, Renee, you've been really successful at getting a private token sale off the ground. How did you go about designing that coin ecosystem for Castbox?
Castbox is a podcast platform, and it already has a lot of listeners and creators as well. And the whole, I mean, currently the whole payment between creators and the consumers are kind of like broken. And we really want to leverage the token economy to incentivize all the core users' behaviors. For creators, you know, when they create great content, we can give them like good tokens as a reward. And for listeners, if they share, report bad content, and if they comment or like do a lot of like the right. actions we appreciate them to do, they can earn their tokens. So this is why we leverage the whole token economy to incentivize the digital content industry.
Well, and you have 600,000 content producers, over 80 million users. You've grown it fantastically and raised 30 million of equity to make all this happen. How do you then identify which are the good content producers that people will actually want to pay more for?
Yeah, I think now we are leveraging the machine learning and collaborative filter algorithm. So we try to understand and remember all the behaviors the user did. For example, the CTR, the listening through rate, and the share rate, to understand whether it's a good quality content or not, and then make the recommendations based on the specific users. And beyond that, we do an in-audio search, which is we use a kind of like a Google search, but for audio world. So we transcript all the audio into text and read the text, understand what they are talking about, understand the categories, topics, the keywords they mentioned, and then do a better recommendations based on the better understanding of the content.
Once you have that information, you're able to bring those premium content producers to the forefront?
Yeah, exactly. So, and also those data help us to understand what kind of like content users may like. And based on that content, we also launched our Castbox original shows, just like Netflix, you know, do their Netflix original. We are doing our original shows.
So the token ecosystem is really taking off in your context, but there have been some challenges in China surrounding this with respect to regulations. What do you think the right move should be to permit the adoption to continue with cryptocurrencies?
Well, since you mentioned that, Tony, last year, September 4th, Chinese government basically shut down all initial coin offering, ICO. All the exchanges also shut down, which created a really interesting dynamic. You know, I always like to say that Chinese have gambling blood. right. Even though the Chinese government shut down, there are still many, many amazing entrepreneurs continue to focus on creating blockchain technology.
Right, where there's a will, there's a way. People are going to find a way
That's
to
right.
do it.
So therefore, a lot of many of these Chinese founders now have went overseas. I see many of them in Hong Kong, in Singapore, in Silicon Valley, in Japan, Korea, everywhere. So therefore, I think that in some way, they're a little bit sensitive right now, but it really pushed the Chinese entrepreneur to be even more global.